staring at the edge of the water, long as I can remember, never really knowing why. I wish I could be the perfect daughter, but I come back to the water, no matter how hard I try. Every turn I take, every trail I track, every path I make, every road leads back to the place I know, where I cannot go, where I long to be. See the line where the sky meets the sea, it calls me, and no one knows how far it goes. If the wind in my sail on the sea stays behind me, one day I'll know. If I go, there's just no telling how far I'll go. I know everybody on this island seems so happy on this island. Everything is by design. I know everybody on this island has a role on this island, so maybe I can roll with mine. I can lead with pride, I can make us strong. I'll be satisfied if I play along, but the voice inside sings a different song. What is wrong with me? See the light as it shines on the sea.
Take a look around and see the world we think we know, and then look closer. There's more to life than meets the eye, a beauty to behold. It's all much bigger than we know. It's only just beginning to unfold, so let it all unfold.
Oh, my breath, scared to rock the boat and make a mess. So I said quietly, agreed politely. I guess that I forgot I had a choice. I let you push me past the breaking point. I stood for nothing, so I fell for everything. You held me down, but I got up, already brushing off the dust. You hear my voice, you hear that sound, like thunder gonna shake the ground. You held me down, but I got up, get ready cause I've had enough. I see it all, I see it now, I got the eye of the tiger. The fire, dancing through the fire, cause I am a champion, and you're gonna hear me roar louder, louder than a lion, cause I am a champion, and you're gonna hear me roar. You're gonna hear me roar.
Now I'm floating like a butterfly, stinging like a bee, I earned my stripes.
It is my pleasure to welcome the Honorable Juliana O'Connor Connolly, Minister for Education, Youth, Sports, Agriculture, and Lands. Miss Barbara Connolly, elected member for Georgetown South, Counselor for Education. The Honorable Dwayne Seymour, Bodentown MLA, Minister of Health, Environment, Culture, and Housing. Mr. David White, elected member for Georgetown West, Counselor for Sports and Transport. Mr. Christopher Saunders, elected member for Bodentown West. The Honorable Anthony Eden, elected member for Savannah. Mr. Elva Siku, elected member for Newlands.
Ms. Antonia Cacho, Chief Officer in the Ministry of Education, Youth, Sports, Agriculture, and Lands. Ms. Lanith Montique, Deputy Chief Officer in the Ministry of Education, Youth, Sports, Agriculture, and Lands. Mrs. Tommy Hopkins, Acting Director of Education. Mr. Ian O'Connor, Senior Schools Improvement Officer. Mrs. Gloria Bell, Senior Schools Improvement Officer. Mr. Nicholas Obi, Senior Schools Improvement Officer. Mr. Elroy Bryan, Senior Schools Improvement Officer for SEN.
Other distinguished guests, parents, teachers, families, and friends, welcome and thank you for joining us today at our Theoline McCoy School Leaving Exercise for the Class of 2020.
School leaving is a time to muse over and celebrate memories that have been made over the past years. This year has been a unique one. We will certainly have a lot to remember.
As you celebrate with us this morning, please feel welcome and be assured. We are truly appreciative of your support.
Please keep your mic on mute for the duration of this ceremony and refrain from use of the chat function as it will disrupt the flow of this program, which is also being recorded. I would like you to join us in welcoming our MCs Ariana O and Amaya Spence to lead us on this platform.
Thank you, Micah. I really like our theme, Moving Mountains, Chasing Dreams. Life is like a mountain, hard to climb, but is worth the amazing view at the top.
With hard work and dedication, we were able to surpass the challenges. This is truly amazing.
Ernest Hemingway once said, "It is good to have an end to journey toward, but it is the journey that matters in the end." We navigated our journey very well in spite of COVID-19 that came like a treacherous mountain.
Let us give thanks unto God. Therefore, I would like to invite Micah and Thalia to lead us in prayer.
God our Father, we can look back over the last few years and recall the friendships that have formed and the good relationships that we have developed. We thank for all who have enriched our lives in various ways, at home, in school, in church, and in the local community. We ask for healing of what has been negative in the past as we place ourselves into your hands.
Inspire us in the years ahead to live in such a way that we readily apologize when things go wrong, as well as expressing thanks and encouragement to those who are a part of our lives. We give thanks, Father, for the gifts, talents, and skills that you have given to each one of us. We think of people who may have received less than others, but may have much of themselves. We remember to those who have overcome great difficulties and all who have inspired us because they have given their best. In giving thanks for what has been in the past, we ask for your blessing on our present and future. Amen.
Thank you, Thalia and Micah. Now that we have set the pace, I would like you to sit back and savor every moment.
Now we will invite Tasani Lodge and Wesley Pender to read the scriptures.
Jesus said unto him, "If thou canst believe, all things are possible to him that believeth."
Jesus answered them, Have faith in God, for most certainly I tell you, whoever may tell this mountain, be taken up and cast into the sea, and doesn't doubt in his heart, but believes that what he says is happening, he shall have whatever he says. Therefore, I tell you, all things whatever you pray for and ask for, believe that you have received them, and you shall have them.
Thank you to Sani and Wesley for the reading of God's holy words.
I will now invite our hardworking and dedicated principal, Miss Walter, to give her remarks.
Good morning and welcome to all joining us from across the screen for our 2020 school leaving ceremony. Protocol having been observed, I would like to express my gratitude towards the Ministry of Education and the Department of Educational Services for their leadership and the plethora of tools provided to us that have enabled us to deliver distance learning in a variety of ways. When the physical doors of our school closed on the 13th of March due to the COVID-19 pandemic, our teachers, students, and parents had to cope with challenges we had all never foreseen. We had to spring into action and face these challenges head on to ensure that we were able to continue to operate by providing learning opportunities to all our students. Our roles, duties, and even the way we solve problems changed overnight, but teachers have persevered through every doubt or uncertainty. They rose up and endeavored to embrace our new normal of teaching and learning. Teachers, please accept my gratitude. Our students engaged in home learning activities, and many worked hard to push themselves to achieve more and more each week. These achievements can be evidenced in our weekly virtual assembly shout-outs, which grew from 2 PowerPoint slides to 8 slides in our final virtual assembly for the year. Students, I applaud you. The parents have been phenomenal in their unwavering support for our distance learning program, communicating with teachers, logging into virtual events, and submitting evidence of work completion. We could not have made such strides without the consistency and guidance given by our parents. Parents, you are appreciated. Confucius said, "Our greatest glory is not in never failing, but rising every time we fail." Through COVID-19, we have seen the mobilization of our stakeholders and the revitalization and development of community partnerships in ways that has been unprecedented. These efforts have meant that there has been greater collaboration of staff, growth and development, sharing of best practices, and connecting at different levels. This journey has led to many innovations that are life-changing, and our school operations have forever been altered as we move towards inclusivity. We are now much more aware of exactly what it will take to move towards a mixed methods approach of online and classroom-based learning. This year will be one to remember. In August, we welcomed a new curriculum and wonderful supporting resources. As a school, we spent time reviewing materials, getting familiar with connecting concepts, and shared with parents in our PTA meetings our plans to support the achievement of our students. For the vast majority, the change was welcomed and positive. We hope to continue implementing all aspects of the curriculum over the next few years. On the 15th of October, our school was renamed to the Theoline McCoy Primary School. Many of our year 6 school leavers were a part of the choir that made such an impact with their performance of Aunt Jemima, led by our music specialist, Mrs. Lau. The choir was so entertaining that they were invited to perform at Bodentown Heritage Day. Our school also placed 2nd and 3rd in the annual Royal Bank Spelling Bee competition, which is much gratitude to our hardworking and dedicated deputy principal, Ms. Yvonne Law Gonzalez, who prepared our spellers well. Our annual Christmas concert was a high-quality production which facilitated collaboration and cohesiveness of our staff. All of our students were very motivated and delivered an enthusiastic performance. On the 24th of January, we hosted a Heroes Day assembly to honor two specially selected school heroes, Mr. Anthony Eden, OBE, elected member for Savannah District, and Ms. Molly Farrell, past principal of then Bodentown Primary School. Additionally, one of our leavers, Wesley Pinder, was named a winner for his story entry in Rotary Sunrise Butterfly Storybook Writing Competition. On the 8th of February, we had another renaming ceremony with our newly surfaced school field. It will now be known as the David Gerard Powell Football Field. What a time we have had, and all before we began our distance learning. During distance learning, we endeavored to stay close together as a school, which seemed so impossible at first. However, we continued to achieve many firsts, beginning with our weekly virtual assemblies, virtual eco-awareness week and vocabulary parade, virtual science fair, virtual career fair, virtual parent meetings, virtual partners in print, and so many of our challenges which kept the spirit and connection to our school going. I really felt the love and support from all stakeholders and members of the community. Next year will be even better. My dear school leavers, I would like to address you directly at this time. You have all been an amazing group of students, and most of you started in the first reception class here at Theoline McCoy School. You can say that you are all pioneers, from being the first receptioners to the first year sixes at our school to engage in distance learning. I can still remember some of your tiny faces that first week of school, and my, how much you've grown since then. I will never forget the times we've shared at the netball and football games, the concerts, competitions like NCFA, and so many more events that have kept our school abuzz. Therefore, I would like to share a few tips with you as you move into high school. Preparation and organization are necessities in high school. You will have all the responsibility of managing yourself, your class schedules, and your time effectively to move across the campus to your various classes. If you are not organized, you might not have the right books or equipment to participate in your lessons to an optimal standard, and of course, you could be late. It is important for you to be a risk taker. There will be many concepts that will challenge you and new things to learn. Be enthusiastic about your lessons. Your new teachers won't expect you to get everything right the first time, but they will be impressed if they see you try your best, and they will help you. I know that you may all have worries about high school because it is new and different from what you already know, but I want to encourage you to be confident. You will get into your new routines and make new friends sooner than you know. Take with you all of the good qualities you have learned and pledged to upkeep as a Theoline McCoy Sunbeam, always being a respectful, responsible, safe, and positive learner. My final word to you all will be to congratulations on achieving this milestone in your education. We have all made it through this pandemic, therefore we can do anything together. I hope that you will all come back to visit so that your teachers can see you all in real life again soon. In the meantime, keep on moving mountains and chasing your dreams.
We have just heard from our principal, and I'm sure everyone is encouraged by her words. Our year group will now sing a song.
close my eyes and I can see the world that's waiting up for me, that I call my own. Through the dark, through the door, through where no one's been before, but it feels like home. They can say it all sounds crazy. They can say I've lost my mind. I don't care if they call me crazy. We can live in a world that we design. Say it all sounds crazy. They can say we've lost our minds. I don't care if they call us crazy. Rock away to a world that we desire.
Thank you, fellow school leavers, for that wonderful rendition of A Million Dreams.
We will now hear from our keynote speaker. Our keynote speaker is our very own Minister of Education, Mrs. Juliana O'Connor Connolly. We are so grateful to her and her hardworking team for what they have provided us in such challenging times.
If this time has taught me anything, it is that the tiny speck in this universe that we occupy is both wonderful and wondrous. And if we allow it to, the beauty around us can unlock the beauty within us and teach us far more than our schooling ever did. If this time has taught me anything, it is that success and how we measure it needs to be redefined, and that the only person to whom you should ever compare yourself is who you were yesterday. Make your growth game strong, and along the way be kind to yourself. If you are doing your best, then you are doing enough. If this time has taught me anything, it is that it is more important now than ever before to see the world through your own eyes. Begin by looking at yourself. Look honestly and look gently. Look inward with compassion and kindness, and look outward with humility and appreciation. If this time has taught me anything, it is that the opposite of love is not hate but fear. And our greatest fear is losing that to which we have become attached. Yesterday is heavy. Put it down. Seeing the beauty in the world around you is the first step in purifying and clearing the mind. And if this time has taught me anything, it is that nature, unlike us, never apologizes for her beauty. If this time has taught me anything, it is that life really is about the journey, not the destination. And it must be, for surely we are not here merely to reach the destination, for the destination is death. Be alive, for after all, life is all you've got. And when you pay attention to the things for which you are grateful, you soon forget about what you think you're missing. If this time has taught me anything, it is that bitter tears are the quietest, and on the days when your head wants to hang low, it is important that you look up, lift your head, take it in and breathe deep. For while this world can sometimes be a hard place, your reality and what you perceive it to be are seldom aligned. If this time has taught me anything, it is that beauty truly is in the eye of the beholder. We can see universes within universes, but only when we pay enough attention. And this is as true of the nature within us as it is of the nature around us. If this time has taught me anything, it is this. If true love conquers everything, then self-love gives it the fortitude to do so. Know that you are more than your scars. Know that every wound in you that has healed along the way has taught you what it is to fight back and to start again from where you are with what you've got. Beat your own pathway without seeking the approval of others, and know that self-love is not vanity. If this time has taught me anything, it is this. Hope matters, and we cannot live without it. This time has taught me that hope is not a wish, nor a desire for things to be different. It is a course of action, a combination of mind and heart. The future can be better and can be brighter, and we each have the power within us to make it so. There will be challenges to face along the way, to which there are many solutions. There is a source of resilience deep within us all. If this time does not teach us that time itself is precious, then we will have missed the lesson. The lesson that never before have the past and the future been so irrelevant, and that the quest to find ourselves has been fruitless to now, only because we've been searching in all the wrong places. We are here. We are now. We are each and every breath we take. Every day is a gift to begin again, and to grasp with both hands the fresh opportunity to learn, unlearn, and relearn. If this time is not wasted.
Yes, this time has taught us that no man, no woman, no boy, no girl is an island. We all need each other to lean on, to hold your hands, to wipe away a tear, to pray with and for us, to provide us with guidance and advice, because two heads, two minds are always better than one. Yes, this time has taught us to be frugal, fiscally responsible, to prioritize budgets, to reorganize plans, to get out of our comfort zone, to navigate uncharted waters and turbulent seas, to reach deep, to find a fresh supply of patience in times when we felt overwhelmed, to exercise our faith even when it seemed like all we had was trembling faith. Yes, this time has taught us to look unto God, from whence cometh our help. It has taught us to be still and to know that God is God, and it is He that has made us and not we ourselves. Yes, this time has taught us that we can accomplish all things through Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. That despite coronavirus circumstances in Cayman, and indeed the entire world, our God is a faithful God. His blessings are new each and every morning. Yes, this time has taught us the usefulness of online learning, e-commerce, computers, smartphones, internet, Wi-Fi, broadband, reliable electricity.
Thank you, Minister O'Connor Connolly, for such an uplifting speech. We will now call on our fellow school leavers to recite our leavers poem adapted from Twinkle, entitled Class of 2020.
We have been together for several years,
sharing our hopes, dreams, and fears.
But in March, we were sent home to stay.
Learning online was our new school day.
We made butterfly pictures to send out a cheer.
Essential workers protecting those we hold dear.
What should have been a time for celebration
became a time of worry and isolation.
But what we have learned in a time like this
is what's truly important and the friends we miss.
It has not been the final year we had hoped.
But we're amazed by our strength and how well we've coped.
Hold on to the memories that we have shared.
Remembering friends and those who cared.
The class of 2020 will hold a place in our hearts.
The courage we've shown from the very start.
We're moving on to somewhere new.
Filled with the confidence we need to see us through.
To all at the school, we wish you the best. Smiles and hard work is the key to success.
We did have some highs and lows this year. However, we have pressed forward and are ready to take the next step into high school.
Oh boy, Ariana, we are getting closer to the best part of this whole ceremony, awards and gifts. However, there is someone very special that we must recognize. Let us take a few moments to make a presentation on behalf of the Ministry of Education and the Department of Education Services for one of their long-serving members, Mr. Errol Levy, who will be retiring at the end of this year. Though he is currently serving the role as Senior Truancy and Registration Officer, he was a past principal here at our school when it was called Bonnetown Primary.
Mr. Errol Levy has over 40 years of experience in education.
He holds a bachelor's degree in education from the City University of New York and a master's degree in educational supervision and administration from Andrews University in Michigan, USA. He has certifications and licensure in special education needs, elementary schools, and was an education officer in New York. Mr. Levy is also a certified project management and educational consultant for K-12 education, including membership in the AASA. He also holds certification in mediation and conflict resolution from the University of the West Indies. Errol Levy began his educational career serving as an elementary school teacher and as a secondary English and mathematics SEN teacher in the New York and Florida education systems for a combined 8 years. Following his return home in the early 80s, he held teaching positions at a number of Cayman Islands primary schools for a period of 16 years. He was appointed as senior teacher at the East End Primary School and specialist teacher at the Georgetown Primary School. His last school appointment was at the Theoline McCoy Primary School, formerly known as the Bordentown Primary School, where he served as teacher and headmaster. He was then promoted to the Department of Education Services, where he has been for the past 17 years. At DES, he redeveloped the position of liaison officer. He was also instrumental in further expanding the post of registration officer and refining all accompanying responsibilities and policies related to that of registration and attendance services in government schools, a post which he holds to date. Mr. Levy is highly versed in education research, education law and accompanying legislations, both local and international. He is a strong advocate for student and parents' rights in education. His teaching philosophy over these years is a very simple one. Once a child enters your sphere of imparting knowledge, he or she doesn't care how much you know until they know how much you care. Mr. Levy's passion for education will continue to thrive as he pursues his dream of being an education consultant to assist students and parents in all aspects of their educational journey through Second Chances Consulting Services. He plans to spend his retirement years with his lovely wife, Amphi, between his adopted country of Cuba and the Cayman Islands, visiting frequently and enjoying their children and grandchildren. He also plans to do occasional expeditionary backpacking tours to far-flung destinations and to volunteer with his favorite charity, Mission of the Poor. He will also devote some time to assisting their guests in a restful nightly experience at their lovely home in the bygone city of Cuba Libre in Havana, Cuba. Mr. Errol Levy, the Department of Education Services and the Ministry of Education wants to publicly thank you for devoting 34 years of unswerving and distinctive service to the field of education in the Cayman Islands. On behalf of the Department of Education Services and the Ministry of Education, we would like to present you with this award. We wish you a happy and enjoyable retirement.
What a wonderful tribute. I especially love to see all the old photos. We wish all the very best on your retirement, Mr. Levy.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, this is the moment we have been waiting for, the distribution of certificates and awards. This is a particularly special time for us today. I can't wait.
Criteria for awards. Academic awards. These special academic awards are presented to those students whose work and dedication demonstrate the importance of maintaining excellent academic grades. These students exemplify our school motto, success through effort, The recipients of the academic awards are recognized for their consistency in reaching or exceeding the required benchmark in reading, writing, and mathematics. Consistent Effort Awards. This award is presented to students who have good work ethic and make their best effort in all aspects of their work. These students have consistently displayed high levels of learning engagement. Most Improved in Academics Awards. The Most Improved Student Award is presented to the individuals who have shown tremendous growth in developing skills to better themselves by demonstrating consistent determination, initiation, and independence throughout the year, which has led to their improved success academically. Exemplary Conduct Awards. This award is presented to students who display excellent behavior in class and while at play, has less than zero incident reports for the year, has not been involved in any serious incidents, and has 5 or more achievement points.
Before awards continue, let me pause to say good morning to everyone. Students who have participated enthusiastically and successfully in all musical activities and have demonstrated passion and competency. They have presented and performed at various functions, both at school and within the community. They have shown competence in using classroom instruments and or their voice to present and perform at a high standard with enthusiasm. The Jerome Graham Victor and Victoris Lodorum Sports Award. Our next award is the Jerome Graham Victor and Victoris Lodorum Sports Award. This award was renamed in 2015 in loving memory of one of our very own past students who excelled in the sporting disciplines and was an extraordinary football player. The late Jerome Lloyd Graham, he not only contributed greatly while he was a student at Badington Primary School, but also assisted tirelessly with the school's football program thereafter. This award is given to the boy and girl who have represented the school well throughout their years at Badington Primary School. A high-level competitor who displays good sportsmanship. Attendance awards. Excellent attendance and punctuality are key ingredients for our students' success. Therefore, we must ensure that students' attendance and punctuality are the highest they can possibly be. In line with the OES, Office of Education Standards requirements, we expect all our students to maintain an attendance level of 99% and above. Thank you.
Wow, we really have achieved a lot. Before we reveal who our top students are this year, let us hear messages from our class teachers.
Dear students, I want to be the first to tell you, congratulations. You have made it. What a year it has been. A year where successes were made, challenges were overcome, mountains climbed, and summits conquered. You should be proud of yourselves. You have done the unthinkable. The world threw you all a curveball that no one prepared you for. But in spite of what seemed like insurmountable odds, you never faltered. Instead, you rose to the challenge and adapted to change. It feels like just yesterday, each one of you entered my classroom, and here you are today, celebrating this amazing milestone in your lives. As I reminisce on the past few months I spent with you, I smile at the moments we shared. The way you learned to set goals, approached new tasks with a positive mindset, made effort when responding to challenges, but most importantly, built confidence in your abilities to progress further. It is truly amazing to see how you all owned your learning. All of these things are invaluable skills that you will be able to carry with you for years as you thrive as lifelong learners. You have proven that you are pioneers on the forefront of a new and innovative form of education. You have demonstrated that no walls, no mountains, or boundaries can diminish what you have accomplished or stand in the way of your hopes and dreams. So as you come to the end of this chapter of your educational journey and embark on the next chapter, it is my utmost wish that you will remain steadfast, that the knowledge gained, the relationships you made, the learning achieved, and the experiences you had during your time here at Theoline McCoy Primary School will serve you well in the years to come. As I close, I want you to know that in life, your plans today will change, and that's okay. Your future is far from predictable. But keep your vision clear, and your goals and aspirations will align. So, like true TMPS stalwarts, go forth in faith. Trust in the Lord with all your heart, and lean not onto your own understanding. In all your ways, acknowledge Him, and He shall direct your path. With respect and admiration, Miss Kogel.
Good morning, everyone. Dear students, I am delighted to be given this opportunity to share with you a final message. This academic year has been a unique, interesting, and surprising one. In August, a group of wonderful students were placed in my care to complete the ascent of a climb that started years ago. The climb was not always easy, but as time elapsed, the atmosphere became more positive, and every one of you started displaying a great sense of responsibility. Secretly, I admired the collaboration and the high level of maturity displayed by many of you, especially the transformations that were made among students who were positively impacted by their classmates' rights and beams. I enjoyed most of the times
we spent together, particularly moments you made me laugh hysterically. COVID-19 crept in like a noxious vine that forced us to retreat behind closed doors. However, like true mountaineers, we continued the climb by taking advantage of virtual platforms and paper-based work. Today, you have reached the end of one milestone. I will paraphrase 2 Timothy 4, verse 7. You have fought a good fight. You have finished this climb. You have kept the faith. Shantina Nalia DeAndro, Giovanni Angelina Kali, Ashley Araya Thalia, Ariana Yeshe Yumi, Dejone Elvis Adam, Caleb Zachary DeAngelo, Wesley Jeremiah Osemar, Everett Jermaine, and Sean. Through COVID-19, you have learned what can be achieved when communities work together and make sacrifices to overcome adversity. We have been reminded of how intertwined our lives are and how our actions impact others. As you transition into high school, keep a winning attitude, patience, politeness, willingness, and most importantly, believe in yourself. You can do it. Climb those mountains and chase your dreams.
Thank you so much, teacher. Now let us see who our top students will be this year.
Principal's Award. Our overall top students must always exemplify our motto, success through effort. In all that they do, they must be role models to their peers and demonstrate a strong work ethic. The following skills and attributes are indicative of a TMPS top student: excellent academic performance, superb leadership skills, self-discipline, involvement in all aspects of school life, displaying an exemplary character throughout the years in school, a caring, responsible, and respectful individual, an individual who handles success with humility.
This year, two students have met these criteria. They are both disciplined and hardworking students. They are always respectful, trustworthy, reliable, and a great example to all. They are dynamic and versatile students. Whether it is an academic event in the performing arts or a sporting occasion, delivering an address, leading devotion, producing an amazing project, welcoming guests, supervising or training younger students, carrying out their duties as a prefect, we can always be certain that it will be done in a way that showcases our expectations and to a high standard. Determination, ambition, excellence are just some of the attributes that have placed them in this enviable position today. They gave their best to be the best.
DJ Bravo, DJ Bravo, DJ Bravo. Champion, 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 champion.
Everybody knows it, Bravo.
Champion, 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 champion.
Everybody know Chris Kane is a
champion.
DJ Bravo, DJ Bravo.
I would like to welcome the head boy and head girl of the prefect body to give the students a draft. Please help me welcome Naomi Ebanks and Wilmer Gonzalez-Challenger to give their remarks.
I am Naomi Ebanks, head girl of Theoline McCoy Primary School for 2020. It has been so difficult to sum up what has been a very special journey for us all at TMPS. Whether you started at the very beginning in reception or whether you joined us later, this year 6 of TMPS is like one big family. To highlight the good times is a difficult task, but what I can say is that all the years at TMPS has been full of wonderful memories. It is a time in our lives that we will cherish and look back on as the most important time in our young lives. Today is an ending, but endings don't have to be sad. Year 6, our final year at TMPS, was disrupted by the unprecedented events of COVID-19, and we were forced to separate and finish our school year at home online and via Teams. It was difficult to do this because we missed being with each other and with our teachers, Ms. Coble and Ms. Simpson. We missed you both so much these past few months, but we want to thank you both for your patience with us as you struggled to teach us online, and we know you all missed us too. There may be tears, laughter, a whole range of emotions right now, but not because we are heartbroken, but because we are reflecting on our time at TMPS with love and happiness. There have been hard times, but above everything, as a year group, we have worked hard, and when we needed to pull, and when we needed to, we pulled together as a group and worked it out. There have been some truly special moments, ranging from our many school field trips to our exciting heritage days and career days. Rest assured, we won't forget any of it. So how do we measure our time, CMPS? In the beginning, we measured it class by class, day by day, counting down until the holidays. We've measured it in terms and years as we have grown from being little kids into young boys and girls. But I know that as I stand here today, I will measure my time here in a different way. I will measure it in terms of the lifelong friendships I've made and the unforgettable memories I have made. Nothing could ever replace the feeling of being at TMPS. We were doing what we do best, learning, having fun, and sharing and caring for each other. As we move on to high school, some of us together, some of us to different schools, we give a big thank you to our teachers for supporting us no matter what, and for putting up with our silliness and craziness. You all have taught us how to be intelligent, responsible, and mature young boys and girls. Our time at TMPS has come to an end, but there is no doubt that we will forever be TMPS children. You can take us out of TMPS, but you can't take the TMPS out of the child. The final thing I want to say is to my classmates, good luck to everyone. I am truly so proud to say that I am a member of this special year group. I look forward to moving on to high school with those of you who are going to Clifton, and I will miss those of you who are not. But let us pledge to stay connected and to stay in touch. I wish you all the best wherever you go and in all that you do. To all of my teachers and principals of TMPS, I love you all and will miss you all dearly.
Good morning, teachers, students, classmates, our dedicated parents, and all other attendees on this virtual platform. We gather here today to celebrate 7 long years of endless work and determination. Through these years, we learned and struggled. We cried and shouted. We failed and succeeded. We lost and won. Through these years, we experienced the feeling of determination that fueled us on this long journey of school. When my current friends and I first came here, we were all scared, even of each other. However, the teachers helped us come together, and we ended up as great friends. I hope that everyone at Theoline McCoy Primary School can be friends, children and teachers alike. As we progress into high school, we recognize the amount of work that was put into shaping our minds. Now we must decide how to shape our future. The past doesn't matter anymore. We must decide what matters. We must decide when it matters. We are all that matters, us. We leave Theoline McCoy Primary School today, but there are other mountains to climb. We are still young and have many more milestones to reach. We will need to employ dedication and determination to surpass our struggles. The teachers here are not the ones taking the test at the end of the year. We are. My fellow school leavers and the remaining student body at Theoline McCoy Primary School, Let us strive to be the best. When you are the best, you can't just sit around lazily. You must continue to challenge yourself and to become greater than you already are. I ask of you, even the little reception kids, to man up and be the ones on stage to receive the most medals, trophies, and certificates. Be competitive with your learning, and you will find yourself learning faster than ever before. Your head boy, Wilmer Gonzalez Challenger.
Thank you, Naomi and Wilmer. How can we end without a vote of thanks? Dejanay Simmons and Haitian Labor will now give the vote of thanks.
Masters of Ceremony, our most valued and invited guests, ladies and gentlemen, it is my privilege to have been asked to offer a vote of thanks on this occasion.
On behalf of the Theoline McCoy School and the school leaving class of 2020, I extend our gratitude to everyone who has joined us on this virtual platform today.
A big thank you to our keynote speaker for such an inspiring and motivational speech. I am almost certain that everyone is motivated by your great and convincing words.
I must mention our deep sense of appreciation to our MCs who have steered the program in such an ably and interesting manner. I would also like to express gratitude to our principal, Ms. Kimberly Waller, and our deputy principal, Mrs. Long Gonzalez, who have also prepared us for the next level of our education. Again, we salute all of our teachers.
Thank you all for being such wonderful teachers, exemplary role models, and caring people. Thank you for knowing your subjects and sharing your knowledge, and for answering the call to be teachers.
The canteen staff, thank you for catering to our nutritional needs. A healthy body with a healthy mind. Mr. Bodden and Mr. Rothman, we also appreciated your valuable service.
Miss Judy, our office manager, we thank you for all you do. To our dedicated and loving parents, I am sure you are proud of us this morning. Thank you for the many sacrifices you have made for us.
All right. I just want to congratulate all of our school leavers. Stay tuned. We have more to show you. And remember, there's a drive-through parade today at our school at 2:30. So we hope to see you all then.
I can almost see it, that dream I'm dreaming, but there's a voice inside my head saying, you'll never reach it. Every step I'm taking, every move I make feels lost with no direction. My faith is shaken, but I gotta keep trying. Gotta keep my head held high. There's always gonna be another mountain. I'm always gonna wanna make it move. Always gonna be an uphill battle. Sometimes I'm gonna have to lose. It ain't about how fast I get there. Ain't about what's waiting on the other side. The struggles I'm facing, the chances I'm taking, sometimes might knock me down, but no, I'm not breaking. I may not know it, but these are the moments that I'm gonna remember most, yeah. Just gotta keep going.
Battle, and sometimes I'm gonna have to lose.
students, let me offer my final congratulations to you. I'm so very proud of all you've accomplished. I love to see how some of you decorated your backgrounds there. I see Wilmer, Amaya, Linaya, Asia. We are so proud of you. Congratulations. You've made it to the end of primary school. Clap for yourselves as well. Awesome. You did an amazing, amazing job. We're super proud of you. And I hope to see you all driving through at our drive-through parade later on today. And those of you who are coming to pick up your gift packets and your certificates, remember to come at your specified time so that you can get your photo up on this beautiful stage here behind me. So hopefully we'll see you all later at 2:30. Enjoy the rest of your day. Thank you, teachers. Thank you to all staff for your hard work and everyone joining. Parents, well-wishers, family members, Department of Education Services, Ministry of Education, we thank you all for tuning in this morning. They have done amazing. Thank you for all of your support. Bye. If you want to say goodbye to your teachers and friends, year sixes, it's your time to speak now.
Bye.
Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye.